Telemedicine has been a boon during the COVID pandemic, where physical and social distancing has become the norm. You can access a doctor's help staying at home in the comfort of your home, and probably that you think would be the right prescription. But unfortunately, telemedicine has limitations. The pillars of medical diagnosis and treatment is based on a complete history taking and physical examination. And the ritual of physical examination is not feasible when you resort to telemedicine. I recently had a patient who came to me complaining of tiredness. He put it down to hard work during erratic times and also that he was not sleeping well. But on examining him, I found that his heart rate was fast, the neck veins were engorged, his heart sounds suggested failure, and also that he had swelling in the legs. Putting all this together, I diagnosed the reason for his tiredness was heart failure rather than lack of sleep and overwork. Similarly, when you see patients by telemedicine, because you are not able to auscultate them, when a patient complains of cough and maybe fever, you tend to be more liberal giving antibiotics to play safe so that infections or pneumonias are not missed. But of course, telemedicine has its use. It is very useful when you have to access a doctor from a remote area or if you are unable to visit the doctor. It is useful especially during routine follow-ups for patients who may have diabetes or high blood pressure. You can monitor the blood pressure at home, similarly the sugar levels at home, and take the doctor's advice on how we need to modify treatment. It is also very useful for issues related to psychological health, and mental health issues are a problem during COVID times. So reaching out to a doctor is very easy through telemedicine. We also, of course, have other issues of poor connectivity due to network problems in India. So remember, telemedicine is useful, but has its limitations. So whenever and wherever possible, please make a visit to see your doctor.